Hi, and welcome to another TaskSap video. Today we have a feature missed by many users. I'm Steve, and today I'll show you the Task Context menu, what the options do, and how to use them. If you find these videos useful, please like and subscribe so you don't miss future videos. Right, Task menu. I've already created a list with a few tasks. So first, how do we open the Task menu? Easy, just tap and hold on any task, like this. After a second or so, we see a drop-down list of options. The first option is Move to Top. If we tap it, we see Task 3 move to the top of our list. There is a corresponding Move to Bottom option, so to move Task 3 to the bottom, long press the task again and tap Move to Bottom. Great! Note, the Move to Top and Bottom options are only available when our Sublist Sort option is set to User Draggable. Next, we have Move Task. This is a shortcut to move a task to a different sublist. Tap it and we see a sublist selection dialog. I have another sublist, so I'll select that. See how our task disappears from the current list, then is moved to the selected sublist. Up next, we have Share Task. This is the same as the share icon at the top of the task detail screen. We can share the task as plain text with WhatsApp or an email, etc. Click the option and select the app you wish to share with. The next menu option is Duplicate Task. As the name suggests, this will duplicate the selected task and all options, including subtasks. So let's tap it and see the result. This can be very helpful for creating template tasks. Now we have Add to Calendar. Again, like the icon at the top of the task detail screen, this allows us to share a task with our device's default calendar. In my case, the Google Calendar. If I choose task 4, which has a reminder enabled, we see that the date and time is passed to the Google Calendar. Let's save our new calendar item and go back to tasks. Up next, we have Highlight. Tap it and our task is highlighted in a light version of the list colour. We can select Highlight again to remove the highlight. Now, for tasks with subtasks, the next option can be very useful. It is Remove Completed. If I expand task 1 so that we can see the subtasks, then I select Remove Completed, we see all our completed subtasks are deleted. This is great for removing clutter. Finally, we have Delete Task. If we tap it, the task will be deleted. As always, we see a temporary undo action at the bottom of our screen. If we miss this, deleted tasks are moved to the deleted items list in the main menu, and so can be recovered later. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. If it was helpful, please like and subscribe to help support my work. It's very much appreciated. If you have suggestions for improvements, please comment below or send me an email. Finally, if you need any help with anything in tasks, just send me an email. Details are in the video description, or again, leave a comment and I'll do my best to reply.